creature that you just saw isn't an alien or mythical monster. They are remnants of prehistoric microorganisms that once lived in our planet millions of years ago.
We might be familiar with huge fossils like dinosaur bones or footprints, but the fossils these microorganisms left behind are very tiny and can only be properly analyzed through a microscope. And that's why their name, microfossils. There can be different kinds of microfossils, and they come in many unique shapes and sizes. New species of microfossils are still being found, and it's amazing how unique they are from one another. Now, if these fossils are so tiny, how do scientists collect them? And why collect these fossils at all when you have big fossils like T-Rex skulls or ammonites? Well, bigger is always better, right? Right? Let's find out. Collecting the microfossils requires a very thorough process, which includes collecting the samples, which are mostly limestone and shale, breaking them down, separating the particles using petroleum, sifting them through multiple sieves, and drying them.
Take your time!
Approximately 10 hours later.
After being dried overnight, we get sand-like particles, and then we are ready to take a closer look. Looking like specks of sand through the naked eye, these microfossils look very different under a microscope. You will find yourself looking into a vast alien land filled with multiple species of microfossils. Separating the microfossils from mineral particles and shell fragments can take a lot of time, but once you find some microfossils, you can analyze them further under a scanning electron microscope, or SEM. The SEM emits electrons onto the specimens to bring out even the tiniest of details. From here, you can move on to identifying and classifying the microfossils from known sources such as microtags. Microtags has the most recent microfossil records, and you can cross-check them with your findings to narrow down their classification. Now, let's see how microfossils are formed and why they are so important in geosciences. In simple terms, when a creature or organism gets rapidly buried by sediments, any organic material is stripped away, and under immense pressure from ever-building sediments on top, water carries in minerals, which slowly mineralize the remains, turning them into fossils. The same happens with microfossils. When they die, they get rapidly buried by sediments, leaving behind their fossilized remains. The principle of faunal succession tells us that newer fossils always lie on top of older fossils. Superposition also gives us a similar principle that older strata occur below younger strata. When these two principles are considered together, we can get an idea about biostratigraphy, which is the specific branch of stratigraphy that uses fossils found in strata to serve as biological markers and give a more precise estimate of the rock unit's age. Microfossils are crucial for biostratigraphy. As they are so diversely abundant in fossil records, they can be used as biological markers to determine the age of the surrounding rocks. This information is crucial for geoscientists and researchers, and also oil and gas, mining, and related industries.
To understand the importance of microfossils even better, let's talk to an expert, Dr. Puhana. He's an associate professor at the University of Texas at Dallas.
Oh, there are microfossils in the Cambrian, there are microfossils in the very recent, in the Holocene. So you will find microfossils very much anywhere where the preservation happens. So here, in this piece of the Austin Chalk we have here, this Austin Chalk is absolutely formed by microfossils, even nanofossils, which are one order of magnitude smaller. You know, we use different techniques. We use a microscope, different kinds of microscope. We use scanning electron microscopes down there, take pictures, like the ones over here, and classify them. And in that way, we can tell the age and the environment and know about the past. That's all we do. Thank you.
So, we can see that microfossils, even if they are tiny, they create an immense impact in our day-to-day lives. So the next time you pick up a rock, remember, there could be tiny little creatures that once lived millions of years ago.